I was in Poundworld and I thought, well, there's a Big Clive product right here, because they probably will be very shocked at its quality. I've already had this out of its box just to look at it, and it feels proper tacky. But before we get there, the back is something I read afterwards, because you're supposed to read the instructions first, but you never do, do you? And it says, electrical products can be dangerous if not used correctly. Never leave a charger while you are not in attendance or sleeping. Okay. Unplug as soon as your phone or tablet is fully charged. Now, can you imagine paying hundreds of pounds for your phone or tablet, then paying £3 for this? Well, some people do, and I am one of them. I managed to, my phone's only a very cheap Nokia, but hey-ho. Never pull the cable to unplug the device, as this will damage the cable and may make the product unsafe. It might also damage your phone or tablet. Never allow children to use electrical products. Never at all! Unplug immediately. If you smell burning, observe smoke, or suspect any other fault, check your charger cable is compatible with your device before using. I don't even know how you meant to know that. Well, this particular charger, the only ones they had left, was one of them ones, which is no good to me. But it was in Poundworld, and this was £3, and it feels so tacky, so tacky. And this, it feels like I could open with my fingers, and you definitely wouldn't pull this out the wall, because that looks proper loose. I mean, look at that already. Oh, it's cracked already, I think. If I do that, is it bending already? Is it cracking? Oh, no, it's not. I thought it was cracking already then. But this feels so tacky. I wonder if I can just squeeze open with my fingers. Is this going to be another recall for Poundworld Electronics? No, but I've bent the plug already, so I've bent it. So if you don't stand on it, I've bent the pin already. So I think this is another one. It's got like really significantly a lot of plastic in here. And the tinsy-wincy bit of metal for the connection. Right. I'm not as high-tech, obviously, as Big Clive, so I'm just going to stick my knife right in there and make loads of people wince, including myself. This is not recommended. Don't try this at home. If you're watching this, don't copy me. I do not know what I am doing, so do not copy me. Okay? There we are. I think I've warned you all not to do this now. But it feels like this isn't going to take a lot of pressure to open. This is actually putting up more than a fight than what I thought it would. Which is why I've got my Poundland screwdriver. Just stick that right in there, because I don't have a spudger like Big Clive. I've just got to do it like this. Oh, it's actually very good. Oh, what's it say on the USB charger? Is that USB? That's not USB, is it? Is that USB? I thought USB was the other one. Anyway, it says USB charger. Input 100 to 240 volts. Output 5 volts. 1 amp max. Made in China. But so far, so good. Even if it does feel really, really tacky. You watch, but this is like... I don't understand though why this is £3 and not a pound. I mean... Really? So I'm just gonna ram that in there like that. Ah, there we go. Actually, it's much easier to clip off now. I think I've succeeded in opening it. Have I? Is it glued shut? No, it's not. I wonder if anyone thought that broke my screw. No, it's not glued in. It is just clipped in. I think I can just get my fingers in there now and pull it out. Yes, I can. Right, so what have we got? Ah, well, I know that this is good. Because when I've watched Big Clive, I know that's good because that stops the contacts from moving. So this may be actually... Oh, look at them thin wires. Look at them very thin wires, look. And does that move inside? If I move this? No, it doesn't. I thought it would. So what we've got inside? This clippy thing. Which I know is good. But how have they connected these bits together? Inside, it's soldered on. Yeah. So, but I have no idea what any of this means. Absolutely no idea. It's, I don't know what's coming out yet. Yeah, it has. Good. And on the back, I know that you've got to look for separation. I know that now. And is that good separation? I don't know. Oh, but I have noticed something straight away. That looks a bit loose, doesn't it? This bit here. I'll get really close in. That looks a bit long, but obviously I don't know what I'm talking about. So I'm going to stop right there. Now, these bits are going to really long. I took one of these apart a while ago, and these bits was really long like this. And that one there is folded right over next to that bit. But I don't know what any of this means. So I hope this has been absolutely beneficially important. Of course it hasn't. This looks a bit tackily done, doesn't it? Look at all that. Well, that's just peeled off. Anyway. Now that I've opened it, I might as well go further, haven't I? Right, so I've not plugged this in, obviously. I mean, I'm definitely not going to now. That's a big boof of solder there, isn't it? It's like a puddle. Wonder what that's about. Anyway. I hope this nice, soothing late night voice is lulling you to sleep. And hopefully you are now going to sleep and you have now got my videos on autoplay, which means you're just going to watch all my videos. So feel free to drift off to sleep for this very boring, sleepy video. Sleep. Sleep. Now they'll sleep. Scraps, and I'll see you when I see ya.